Hey, great to see you. Right now, I've got 5 tips for you inside of Adobe Camera Raw. Tip number 1, how to apply adjustments to thousands of images all at once. Right-click from Bridge, and we're going to open this in Camera Raw because, first of all, we have to apply an adjustment that we're going to share. So let's just go under the mask, select the person, and let's just grab hair just for an example. Click Create. So I have another tutorial that walks through all of this in depth, and I will add a link to that. All right, so let's just adjust the hair color to make it easy to see that we've changed something. Now, all we do is click Done. When you click Done, it applies the adjustment and goes back to Bridge. You can see an adjustment's been made because the icon here. Now, to copy this smart mask to as many images as we want, right-click, choose Develop Settings, Copy Settings. Click on the images we want to apply it to, and we haven't even created a preset. All we've done is just grabbing the adjustments from one image. We're going to right-click, and we're going to choose Develop Settings, Paste Settings. We're going to choose None, and all we want to apply is the masking. Click OK. And boom, those AI masks are now applied to all those images inside a Bridge without even opening Camera Raw. And tip number 2, how to select anything inside of Camera Raw. So we know Camera Raw and Lightroom can automatically select objects using AI, but they don't always select the right object. So under the mask, we can choose Create Subject, and it kind of sort of picks everything. But what if I just want to get this cog? Let me hold down Alt or Option, hit Reset, and we're going to use the Object Selector. Watch this. Just grab the object selection, and then make a rough selection around the area that you want to select. The key, don't lift your mouse until you're done. Release, and it gets a pretty good selection. Now, how do we fix it? Now, to fix it, just paint to add. If you want to take away, hold down Alt or Option, and it'll give us a minus key. Then we drag the mask out of the way so we can see it. And if there's any areas that you want to perfect, all we do is just choose Subtract, Brush. Then under the brush, make sure you turn on Auto Mask. And you can just paint away those bits that you want to perfect. And now you can make adjustments however you like, and it's just going to affect that area that you selected. Tip number 3, how to color grade a video. Let's color grade video inside of Camera Raw. To get a video into Camera Raw, it's as simple as just opening it in Photoshop. Choose File, Open, find a video file, click Open. And here we have a video clip. So just scrub to a frame that you like, maybe this one. Now here's the secret. The secret is to right click, convert to smart object. If you don't do that, you're only going to edit one frame. Now we can go into Camera Raw and edit the entire video. Watch this. Filter, Camera Raw filter. Here we are in Camera Raw. I can apply presets. Let's go under the profiles. I can apply profiles, presets, whatever I want. Make all the adjustments I want. And then when you're done, click OK to apply. And we now have the color grade applied to the entire video. And tip number 4, hidden helpers. So when we're adjusting our images, there's a hidden keyboard shortcut that can help us. That's Alt on Windows, Option on Mac. And it works in a couple of the different panels. One of them is in the basics panel. And now we want to go and adjust our whites or blacks, but we don't want to go too bright. In other words, lose detail. Hold down Alt or Option, and we can see if I go too far, that area will turn white, which means it loses all its detail. We don't want that to happen. Same thing with blacks. Hold down the Alt or the Option, and as we move, you start to see these areas. Those will be plugged up to pure black and would lose their detail. So we can choose the areas that we don't mind reducing detail in, and we can get a nice adjustment. By the way, this also works in exposure, highlights, and shadows. But this also works while sharpening. go to detail, hold down auto option, and when we go to sharpen, it turns it to black and white so we don't get distracted by the color. And look at this, we can just fine tune everything holding down that alt or the option key. Where do we want to sharpen? Just the edges, the entire image. We can easily see now by holding down the alt or the option key to apply those adjustments. Tip number 5, how to use real color LUTs inside of Camera Raw. You can use a color LUT directly in Camera Raw. Let me show you how. Let's right click in Bridge, choose open in Camera Raw. Now Photoshop comes with a hidden set of LUTs. We can access most of those directly within here. So what we're gonna do is act like we're creating a preset. So we'll click on presets. Now, rather than create preset, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and now it will come up the option to create a profile instead. Let's name this profile, PSC test will work. Now go under the bottom where it says color lookup table, click on it, and here you can load in any LUT you want as long as it's in cube format. And I'll show you how to access the ones that are already inside of Photoshop. I want to navigate to the Photoshop Extras folder. On the Mac, it's under Application, Photoshop, Presets, 3D LUTs. Now, somebody on Windows maybe can drop in the comment where it is. Now you see, some of these are grayed out, but the ones that are cube are accessible. So why don't we grab the candlelight, click load, and that's all we've got to do. Remember the name, underscore PSC test, and where do we want to save it? Let's save it under Photoshop Cafe. Click OK. Now to apply this LUT, all we need to do is go under the profiles, choose the group Photoshop Cafe. There's our PSC test, and notice there's an amount slider so we can determine how much of this LUT we want to apply. And then I've got other LUTs. I'll give you guys a link where you can download some of these for free at the Vault at Photoshop Cafe. So drop a comment and let me know how many of these were new to you. By the way, this is just a little taste from my new Adobe Camera Raw class. 54 lessons, 7 hours, and 20% off for the next week. I'll drop the links underneath. And if you want to know how I created those smart presets, check out this video right here. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.